blackairfoundation.org. What was it like for these young men to come and interview you and film you and cause you to reflect on all those memories, 86 or 87 years of memories?
Yeah, well, I really hadn't thought very much about it, but as we got into it, people started asking me. They said, I didn't know you went to Tuskegee. I didn't know that you were involved with the Tuskegee Airmen. And so it's been quite an experience for me. They've inspired me to form an organization called the Black Air Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
And the Black Air Foundation is aimed at getting young inner-city kids into aviation.
Hmm.
And my nephew has an airplane, and we've set up a program that we think will allow them to familiarize themselves with the aviation and give them a ride in the airplane. We're trying with this idea of connecting people in radio, television, and filmmaking to get more information out to them that will inspire them to do better. So we need to get the other message across. And that's another part of our problem.
Well, we want to talk more to you about that in terms of communication. And tell us what the experience has been for you working with Napoleon and other young people.
Well, it's been very exciting to me to deal with these young people and the talents that they have.
Mm-hmm.
We have people involved in radio and television, and we're trying to put together this organization because Rhode Island, there was an article in the paper the other day. They call Rhode Island the Hollywood and Rhode Island. So we're trying to get these young people interested in filmmaking because there's going to be a lot of opportunities, I think.
His foundation is blackairfoundation.org. We encourage you to go and check it out and learn more about blacks in aviation.